gentlemen, boys and ghouls, step right up. Behind this curtain lies a ghastly concoction of delight, horror, fantasy, and terror. Your every wish is our command. Your every whimsical desire brought to life. But I'm warning you, there's always a price. Welcome to the greatest show on
Sorry I never got the movie Mouse portion down for this animation, but due to time constraints, I really couldn't manage it at the time, so I hope you don't mind, and let's continue with this. My name is David Pena Jr., and I'll be your guide for this project. Let's start with the programs that have been a part of me while my attendance here at ITT Technical Institute. These programs include 3D Studio Max, and of the Adobe suite, Adobe Illustrator, After Effects, and Photoshop. ITT Technical Institute offers more multimedia programs, but these have been my main ones that I've excelled at and used on a regular basis while attending here. Does anybody else hear that? What's that sound? Where is it coming from? It sounds really annoying. Oh. Spook-licious. This was my first animation in 3D modeling and... Whoa! Is it gone? Huh! Well. Well, looks like a portal has just opened to this project. I say we go in. Alright, let's do this. We can do this. All you gotta do is just jump in and see where it goes. Here we go! Oh, that was a rough landing. Welcome to Spooklicious, IT309T Animation 1. This course is a continuation of the 3D modeling course. Principles of form topology, visual design, and movement are applied in the creation of simple animated sequence. So, let's examine the structure of this project. Each character is made of simple shapes. Take Spook here. The basic structure is your ovals, spheres, triangles, pyramids, and cylinders. Just placed and colored in the right spots, grouped together gave me a unique character modeled. Alright, now let's get them back together. Thank you there, Spook. Now, what can that be? Huh. Guess I was running late. Ah. Looks like our next adventure waits. Storyboard. Let's go visit an old friend of mine. I hope this bad boy can hold me. Now, this journey might be dangerous, and I have no idea if we will come out alive. But be brave. We will overcome. So let's stop wasting time and get the show moving. Alright, we have to find our targets here somewhere. Keep your eyes peeled. There we go, I think we're coming up on him. Yep, that's our guy. Let's go pay a little visit. Ooh, that was a little more intense than what I thought. Alright, IT311T, Animation 2. This course is a continuation of Animation 1. Students will be introduced to methods of intricate lighting, texture mapping, rendering, and the finer details of motion graphics to create 3D computer animated solutions. Techniques of concept development, storyboarding, project planning, and script writing will be applied during the creative process of generating a computer animated sequence. That is a mouthful. So, let's analyze a little character here and see what all that really means. So, Animation 2 was the basic structure of building a full character with moving bones and controls. So if we go to X-ray mode, you can see all the controls that control every part of my body, all these little circles. So if we take away the head, you can see the actual skeletal system for the head. Now we take away the body, and you can see the full skeletal system. So let's go into a more perspective mode. That way you can see a full 3D image of what's going on here. Now these look extremely simple, but it's actually extremely hard. All the fins you see that are popping out of the bones, those control the envelope to the skin of the actual character. So those control the actual character, the envelopes. Now if you had, let's say the hand, we'll take the hand for example. If you had the hand and that whole envelope controlled the whole body, that whole fin controlled the whole body, you would have an extremely messed up character when it came to animating. Now during rendering, your final output, all these controls will disappear and all the texture mappings will show up a lot better. So this is pretty much what I'm seeing as I animate these characters. Alright, let's get you back down. Alright, let's take a break. I mean, we've been skydiving, free falling, riding planes. Oh, we need a break. Or not. One-eyed doll. Whoa, that is a big one. Alright, now we just gotta find a way to get down. And we'll be all set. He pushed me off. I didn't think stripping you naked would get you that mad. Okay, this is the, alright, you got to excuse me, I have to stretch after that one, that really did hurt. Alright, so, how about I recover for a bit and you take a tour of this little facility for a second. Alright, now if you're not too dizzy, we could continue with this. Now what really made this project what it is the characteristics of the actual person into the animation and the structure of the character's heads. The polygon system for the head is extremely huge, that's why everything looks a little bit more jagged and, you know, it's not as fine-tuned as the singer's. So I wanted his face to match the actual person, which was incredibly difficult. Her head alone took about a week of work to do. That's only because her head is made up of thousands and thousands of polygons. Your triangles, well, look who came to the show. I guess they're ready to rock and roll. I thought it was important not to show too much about this project. It's a combination of Animation 1 and Animation 2 outside of school. So, I hope you enjoyed this presentation. Enjoy the show.